Now, in the next two sections, there is a story, a journey which Hazrat Musa alayhi salatu wasalam took with someone. We are not sure who was he, whose name is not given. Generally, we know him by the name of Khidr alayhi salam. There are various opinions about the person of and personality of Khidr. One is that he was an angel sent down on this earth so that he teaches to Hazrat Musa alayhi salatu wasalam some of the wisdom, divine wisdom. Some think that he was a saint dead long before, but his spirit is there and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has retained it in this world and it guides people on different occasions, etc., etc. But I think there's no need of going into this discussion. Only the essence of what he taught and what is the reality that Moses came to know through him, that is important. فَإِذْ قَالَ مُوسَىٰ لِفَتَاهُ. Just recall when Moses said to his servant, لَا أَبْرَهُ حَتَّىٰ أَبْلُغَ مَجْمَعَ الْبَحْرَيْنِ أَوْ أَمْضِيَ حُقْبًا. I am not going to give up until I reach the place where the two rivers or two seas, they meet. You know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told him, go there where the two rivers or two seas, they meet. And there you will find a person. And he will teach you certain things. Now, there are two opinions. One is that this was the Nil, River Nile. Al-Nilul Arzak, Al-Nilul Abyas. There are two Niles, you know, in Sudan. But then they join together. And when it enters Egypt, it is one Nile. So maybe the joining place of the two Niles, you know, the blue Nile and the white Nile, might be that place where he was sent. Wallahu alam. So he said, I am not going to give up till I reach there, where the two seas or rivers meet. Or I can go on for years. فَلَمَّا بَلَغَ مَجْمَعَ بَيْنِهِمَا. When they both reached the point of meeting of those two rivers, نَسِيَا هُوتَهُمَا. They had for their, you know, breakfast or something like that, some fish, roasted fish. They forgot to take with them. نَسِيَا هُوتَهُمَا. فَاتَّخَذَ سَبِيلَهُ فِي الْبَحْرِ سَرَبًا. Now this roasted fish became alive and dug a burrow in the sand and went into the sea or the river. فَلَمَّا جَاوَزَا. When the both of them had gone further, قَالَ لِفَتَاهُ. Now Musa said to his servant, آتِنَا غَدَانَا. Bring us that breakfast, our food. لَقَدْ لَقِينَا مِنْ سَفَرِنَا هَذَا نَصَبًا. Now we have tired. We have got it, you know, from this journey, we have been tired now. قَالَ أَرَيْتَا. The servant was Joshua, of Bible, Joshua. And we call them Yusha ibn Nun. Joshua, he became the caliph after Hazrat Musa, alayhi salatu wasalam. And under his leadership, the Bani Israel, they captured Jericho. Jericho is the city, which was the first city which was captured in Palestine by Bani Israel under the command of Joshua. And this Joshua is as a servant with Hazrat Musa alayhi salatu wasalam in this journey. Qala ra'aita. Joshua said to him, look, izawaina ila sakhrati. When we had taken refuge on that chattan, on that sakhra, on that rock, فَإِنِّي نَسِيتُ الْهُوتِ. I just forgot to look after that fish. وَمَانْ سَانِيهُ إِلَّا الشَّيْطَانُ نَذْكُرَ. Definitely, Satan made me forget that I didn't mention it to you. وَاتَّخَذَ سَبِيلَهُ فِي الْبَحْرِ. عَجَبًا. And that fish, that became alive, and then it took its way into the sea or into the river. And it's a very strange thing that has happened. قَالَ ذَلِكَ مَا كُنَّا نَبْغِي. Moses said, Musa alayhi salam said, this is what we were looking for. Allah has told him that something very strange will happen somewhere, and there you will find the person to whom we are sending you. قَالَ ذَلِكَ مَا كُنَّا نَبْغِي. He said, this is what we were after. فَرْتَدَّ عَلَىٰ أَصَارِهِمَا قَصَصَىٰ. Now they retraced their steps and came back to that place where the two rivers were meeting. and where that fish had disappeared into the water. فَوَجَدَ عَبْدًا مِنْ عِبَادِنَا. There they found our bondsman, one of our bondsmen, عَبْدًا مِنْ عِبَادِنَا, one of our servant, from our servants. آتَيْنَاهُ رَحْمَةً مِنَّا. We had given him mercy from us. وَعِلَّمْنَاهُ مِنْ لَدُنَّا عِلْمًا. And we had taught him knowledge from the store of knowledge with us. قَالْ لَهُ مُوسَى. Musa said to him, هَلْ أَتَّبِعُكَ. Should I follow you? I remain with you, keep your company. عَلَىٰ أَنْ تُعَلِّمَنِ مِمَّا عُلِّمْتَ رُشْتَى. But you will have to teach me some of what you have been taught of right judgment. Some of the knowledge, special knowledge that Allah has given you. If you promise to teach me, then I should remain with you for some time, for some days. قَالَ إِنَّكَ لَنْ تَسْتَطِعَ مَعِيَ صَبْرًا. He said, you won't be able to have patience with me. وَكَيْفَ تَصْبِرُ عَلَىٰ مَا لَمْ تُحِطْ بِهِ خُبْرًا. And how can you have patience about those things, about the knowledge of which you don't have? Apparently you will find I am doing something wrong, and you will not be able to keep quiet. You will speak out, and just as happened, we will see later on. So you will not be able to be patient with me. قَالَ سَتَجِدُنِي إِنْشَاءَ. Moses said, inshallah, you will find me patient person. وَلَا أَعْصِي لَكَ أَمْرًا. I will never disobey you. Whatever your instruction, I will follow. قَالَ فَإِنِ اتَّبَعْتَنِي. Then he said, if you follow me, if you keep my company, فَلَا تَسْأَلْنِي أَنْ شَيْءٍ. Then don't ask anything from me, حَتَّى أُحْدِثَ لَكَ مِنْهُ ذِكْرًا, till such time that I myself disclose to you some of the secrets of what I have been doing. فَانْتَلَقَ. Now they departed. حَتَّى إِذَا رَكِبَ فِي السَّفِينَةِ. But when they boarded a boat, خَرَقَهَا. He made a hole in the boat, bottom of the boat. قَالَا خَرَقْتَهَا لِتُغْرِقَ أَهْلَهَا. How could Hazrat Musa be patient with it? He said, you have made a hole in the bottom of the boat. You want to drown its occupants. لَقَدْ جَيْتَ شَيْءٍ إِمْرًا. Certainly you have done a very grievous thing. قَالَ أَلَمْ أَقُلْ إِنَّكَ لَنْ تَسْتَطِيعَ مَعِيَ صَبْرًا. He said, didn't I say to you, you will not be able to be patient with me. قَالَ لَا تُعَذِذْنِي بِمَا نَسِيتْ. He said, and you don't bring me to the book on which I have forgotten. It was just, you know, I forgot. Reproach me not for which I forgot. وَلَا تُرْهِقْنِي مِنْ أَمْرِي عُسْرًا. And oppress me not in my affair. فَانْتَلَقَ. He said, okay. Then they continued their journey. حَتَّى إِذَا لَقِيَ غُلَامًا فَقَتَلَهُ. Till that time that they met a young boy, and he killed him. قَالَا قَتَلْتَ نَفْسًا زَكِيَّةً بِغَيْرِ نَفْسٍ. Musa said, you have killed a human life, innocent life, without his having killed anybody. No law. لَقَدْ جَيْتَ شَيْءٍ نُكْرًا. Again you have done something very bad. قَالَ أَلَمْ أَقُلْ لَكَ إِنَّكَ لَنْ تَسْتَطِيعَ مَعِيَ صَبْرًا. That person said, didn't I say to you that you won't be able to have patience with me? قَالَ إِنْ سَأَلْتُكَ عَنْ شَيْءٍ بَعْدَهَا فَلَا تُصَاحِبْنِي. Hazrat Musa said, now if I ask anything again, then you can say me to depart. Then don't keep me with you. لَقَدْ بَلَغْتَ مِنْ لَدُنِّي عُذْرًا. You have reached now that level of excuse about me. I won't be able to complain that why you are parting ways from me. Because twice I have committed a mistake, but if a third time I commit a mistake, you will be justified to say, go away. فَانْتَلَقَ. Again they continued the journey. حَتَّى إِذَا أَتَيَا أَهْلَ قَرْيَةٍ اسْتَطْعَمَا أَهْلَهَا. Till such time that they came to a township, and they wanted the people of that town or village to feed them. Travelers, you know, in the olden times, people used to feed them as guests. فَأَبَوَا يُزَرْيُفُهُمَا. But those people were so wicked of that township that they refused to feed them and to play host to them. فَوَجَدَا فِيهَا جِدَارًا يُرِيدُ وَيَنْقَبْوَا. Now they found there in that city or township a wall which was going to collapse. فَأَقَامَ. That person, Uzair, that person, Khidr, he straightened it, rectified it. قال لو شئت لاتخذت عليه اجرا. حضرت موسیٰ said, you could demand, you know, labor from them. They are so wicked people, they are not ready to feed us, and you have done this work for them without any wages. You should have demanded wages. قال هذا فراق بيني وبينك. He said, now this is the parting of time. This is the time of parting of ways between me and you. سَأُنَبِّئُكَ بِتَعْوِيلِ مَا لَمْ تَسْتَطِعْ عَلَيْهِ صَبْرًا. Now I am going to disclose to you the secrets about which you couldn't be patient. Number one, أَمَّا السَّفِينَةُ, as for that boat, فَكَانَتْ لِمَسَاكِينَ يَعْمَلُونَ فِي الْبَحْرِ, that belonged to certain poor people who were working on the sea, taking passengers from this side to that side. فَأَرَدْتُ أَنْ أَعِيبَهَا, and I intendedly, I damaged it. وَكَانَ وَرَاهُمْ مَلِكٌ يَأْخُذُ كُلَّ سَفِينَةٍ غَصْبًا, because behind them there was a king who was confiscating and annexing all the boats. Now when he will see that this boat is damaged, he will spare it. So this whole boat will be spared for them. Had it been correct and absolutely fit, then the whole boat would have gone from them. So actually, you think that I have done something bad for them, it is actually good for them, for their benefit, that now that king will not take this boat from them. وَأَمَّا الْغُلَامُ, as for that boy, فَكَانَ أَبَوَاهُ مُؤْمِنَيْنِ, his parents are believers, and they are good people. فَخَشِينَ أَنْ يُرْهِقَهُمَا طُغْيَانًا وَكُفْرًا, we fear that if this boy becomes mature, he will oppress his parents with insolence and ingratitude. He could see that he is not a gentle man, gentle boy. He will be a headache for the parents. فَأَرَدْنَا أَنْ يُبْدِلَهُمَا رَبُّهُمَا خَيْرًا مِنْهُ زَكَاةً وَأَقْرَبَ رُحْمًا. So we decided that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes him back and give them in his place another son who might be better than him in purity and nearer in affection. وَأَمَّا الْجِدَارِ, and as for the wall, فَكَانَ لِغُلَامَيْنِ يَتِيمَيْنِ فِي الْمَدِينَةِ, it belonged to two orphan boys in the city. وَكَانَ تَحْتَهُ كَنْزٌ لَهُمَا, beneath the foundation of that wall, there was a treasure for them. وَكَانَ أَبُوهُمَا صَالِحًا, and the father of these two orphans, he was a very pious person. He had saved something for his young orphan sons, you know, when he was dying. And he buried there in the foundation of this wall. Now if this wall, if it collapses, the treasure will be apparent. It will come out and people will take it. Because the orphans are still minor, they won't be able to protect their wealth. So, فَأَرَادَ رَبُّكَ, so your Lord decided it, أَنْ يَبْلُغَ أَشُدَّهُمَا, they reach their maturity. وَيَسْتَخْرِجَ أَكَنْزَهُمَا, and then they take out from that, the foundation of that wall, their treasure. رَحْمَةً مِنْ رَبِّكَ, all this was manifestation of the mercy of your Lord. Apparently you thought I have done something wrong. Now what is the lesson in it? In this world, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends something to me, which is not pleasant, I think it is bad. Maybe there is something good in it. أَسَانْ تُحِبُّوا شَيْئًا وَهُوَ شَرٌّ لَكُمْ وَأَسَانْ تَكْرَهُوا شَيْئًا وَهُوَ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ. It's just possible. You might be disliking something, but there is good for you in there. And likewise it is also possible that you might like something, but there must be bad in it for you. So actually Allah knows and you don't know. وَاللَّهُ يَعْلَمُ وَأَنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُ. So whatever is happening in this world to us, we should think, is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And some good is intended by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. بِيَدِهِ الْخَيْرِ, in His hand is all good. Whatever comes from Him is good for me. Although apparently, immediately, instantly, it might appear to be unpleasant for me, but in the long run, if it is coming from my Lord, it must be beneficial for me. This is the lesson of Iman, which Hazrat Musa alayhi salatu wasalam got through this journey. ذَلَكَ تَعْوِيلُ مَا لَمْ تَسْتَطِعْ عَلَيْهِ صَبْرًا. This is the real interpretation of those things on which you could not have patience.